Hey folks, how's it going today? Frank Davis here. I'm back to talk about another core exercise that you can throw into your routine. If you missed the last couple of weeks, we've been talking about ways that you can exercise your core, exercise your abs, minus the pain that you might incur over the course of time from doing crunches and sit-ups. So we want to try to find other ways to do that by keeping the spine straight and maybe not bending as much as that. So one of the exercises that I really like to use that really focus on the ab muscles right here, the six-pack muscles that we may be possibly missing by not doing crunches, not doing sit-ups, is a rollout. And a rollout you'll typically see going on in the gym. You see an object like this, which is a wheel, and now we're going to use this to roll out in front of us. So you see this, or you see one of those smaller wheels, but same kind of concept. And what goes on here is I'm going to get into a kneeling position. I'm going to place the roller out in front of me on the floor. Okay. I'm going to drive my hips forward so I get a straight line between my knees and my shoulders. Roll out and pull it back on me. Okay. Drive my hips forward, squeeze my glutes. Roll out, pull it back on me. And you can see, just by having that going on, my abs are pretty much screaming at me at that point. So one of the things about a rollout with the wheel is it's probably the most difficult progression. So everyone may not be able to do this. So an easy way to kind of regress this is to start with something that's probably more readily available to you, like a Swiss ball. You can see these pretty much in any gym or place that you're going to work out. So use a Swiss ball in the same manner. Okay, I'm going to get up nice and tall, straight line between my knees and my shoulders. Get the ball out in front of me at my arm's distance. And now I'm going to drive my hips forward so I get that straight line, get that good activation on my backside, and roll out. And pull it back under. Okay? Drive my hips forward, activate back here, roll out, pull it back under. Roll out, forearms just slide across the ball, pull it back under. Okay? So again, the balls can be an easier progression leading up to working on the wheel, which is pretty difficult for most people. So start here, move to there. An even easier progression to that, if you have it available, would be using a TRX. Okay? So we have a TRX set up right here. And a good way to start, if you have all these pieces of equipment going on, is to use the TRX. So I'm going to set up with the anchor point of the TRX behind me. I'm going to get myself in a straight line from a standing position, a straight line from my toes, my ankles, through my shoulders. Handles are out in front, and now I'm going to let the handles swing out above my head. So I'm rolling out, pulling them back up. Okay? Hands swing out above my head, roll out, pull them back underneath. I can regress this or progress this by stepping forward, give myself less angle. It's going to be easier to do it from here. If I move backward to give myself more angle, it's going to be more difficult and I'm going to have more pressure working from here. Okay, you see I'm having a nice little struggle just trying to maintain that straight posture and pulling it back under. Okay, roll out, straight posture between my ankles and my shoulders and pull it back under. Again, the tension that occurs from having to maintain a straight posture, a straight alignment in my spine, and it really puts a lot of pressure on my six-pack muscles. So try it out, folks. Again, probably the easiest progression is to work from a TRX, go to the Swiss ball, and then go to the wheel afterwards. So again, it will have your abs screaming at you after you do this. Start simple, make sure you can do the exercise correctly, and work your way up. And try to roll out, folks. My name is Frank Daniels. Enjoy.